just announced this fight yesterday. They don't know if it's going to happen on October 17th or October 24th. You have Vasily Lomachenko, one of the best pound-for-pound fighters, against Teofimo Lopez, who's a champion, who's 22 years old, who has insane power and skill. What do you think?
That's another fight that the fans are going to win. Everything I just described about Leo and Tank, that's another fight with Teofimo Lopez and Lomachenko. That's going to be a great fight. Who I got? I got us. I got the fans. I want to see a great fight, and that's what they're going to bring. We all know what Teofimo brings. We all know what Lomachenko brings. So it could be a short night. You know, grab your popcorn, grab your soda, grab your water, grab your beer, and take a seat, because it might end in the first round or it might go 12. We just don't know. But I think whoever has the smarter game plan and has the stamina and makes the adjustments when they need to, that's the guy that's going to come out on top.
Okay, how about this fight? Ryan Garcia, Luke Campbell.
Well, Ryan Garcia is that kid that everybody loves to talk about, but nobody likes. Because, listen, boxing is a business. You know, boxing is a business, and your manager's got to maneuver you to fight the most biggest name with the least risk. So that's what they're doing with Ryan Garcia. Whether you like him or not, it's irrelevant. He's got skills. So with Luke Campbell, it just depends what Luke Campbell shows up. If he's ready to fight, if he's ready to go to toe, and if he could take Ryan Garcia's punch, then who knows how Ryan Garcia is going to act when somebody actually stands up to him. We haven't seen that. So if that's the night Luke Campbell decides to stand up and show Ryan who he is, Ryan might be in for a night.
I got Ryan in that fight. I think he's just improving. He's looking good. He's confident. He's happy. I mean, he's explosive. Yep. He has the reach, the power, speed.
You know what it is? He's young, and everybody wants to see him fight a lion. But at the end of the day, he's young.
23 or 22. He just had a birthday this
week. That's what I'm saying. Like he's young. Everybody wants to see him fight the top guy, because just like when Oscar was fighting, they got tired of listening to him. They got tired of looking at him, because in one way they're envious of the kid. He's a good young kid.
A lot of jealousy.
Kid.
7 million followers.
He's got some money. I mean, come on, man. Who wouldn't want to be Ryan Garcia for a week? I mean,
how many dates would you get?
Oh man, I'd be needing like that. It'd be like the Red Cross in Mexico, picking up everything. You know what I mean? But nah, all kidding aside, I mean, Ryan Garcia, you know, people want to see him win. People want to see him lose.
But they'll watch him.
But they're going to watch. Everybody who says, I'm not going to watch, they're going to watch.
They're lying. Okay, how about this? Freddie Roach mentioned three names for Manny Pacquiao. He said Mikey, Crawford, or Triple G. What do you think of those three fights for Manny?
I'd like to see him fight Mikey.
Why?
Just because, man, you know, Filipino, Mexican, rivalries, fights. You know, Mikey's going to stand there. Mikey's not going to run away. He's going to be right there in his face. And Pacquiao, we all know what Pacquiao brings, but out of those three names you said, I'd like to see him fight Mikey. And yeah, you know, Mikey's a great guy. You know, friend of the gym, hung out with him a few times in Dallas.
Good dude.
Great dude. So yeah, I like to see Pacquiao and, Crawford's a good guy too, be tough for Pacquiao, but I'd like to see, Mikey Garcia get that fight.